Hi everyone, I'm Dave Giancola and welcome back for another episode of a U.S. Women's Open Decade. The growth of women's golf started to bear fruit during the 1980s. Whereas the 60s and 70s saw a lot of the same names in contention year after year at the U.S. Women's Open, there were zero repeat champions in the 80s and only one victor who had previously won the championship. The international nature of the game also started to take root and spread the seeds of the global game we currently know and love. Prior to 1987, the Women's Open only had two foreign-born champions. Then, consecutive international competitors won in 87 and 88. The 80s also featured back-to-back exciting playoffs in 86 and 87 after a long drought of U.S. Women's Open playoffs. Let's take a look back at all the U.S. Women's Open had to offer throughout the 1980s.
Well, it makes it easy with the two-stroke, you know, lead there as far as the second and third place is concerned. She can play 18 a lot easier. For par four.
Yep. And just, she's got it.
Ooh, right, just rattle it right in there.
Even par for the day, 5 under for the championship. If she pars 18, she'll have 279. I suspect that would be a record that might stand for a few years.
A little knocked down 8-iron, way to right, but on the green.
Yep, it's okay, Bob. And if she can get down in two from there, she will have an even par round of 71. There have only been two of those today by Lori Garbazi and Judy Clark. Marked it for a moment to make sure there's no dirt on it or anything.
Yeah, but this adds to her record in the Open, though, too, Jim. Twice winner, runner-up. I mean, you don't like to be runner-up, but still that's shows how well you play in majors.
Well, at age 26, there should be a good many more, maybe first and second for Holly Stacey in this national championship. Two over par round of 73 today for a total of 5 over. That's 288. And now what may be the final shot of this championship. Amy puts it in the hole.
For a bogey, but a score of 280, Jim. That's marvelous playing.
Okay, there it is. A new record by 4 shots for the U.S. Women's Open Golf Championship for Amy Alcott.
That's great.
Isn't that marvelous? And of course, the caddy she embraced there is used to this act. It's the third time he's done it. Twice before with Hollis Stacey. But the woman of the day, of the weekend, Amy Alcott, the new national champion. She'll get $20,000 first prize and that special prize of $25. That's a total of $45 for the weekend.
You know, Pat Bradley's 5 under for the day. She could shoot 67 with pars in. That's a nice touch.
Yes.
Look at that.
Beautiful. Especially after Bradley makes the putt ahead of her.
Oh, yes.
And those really are looking the shots of a champion, and a great champion at that. The way she pushed that one in, beautiful shot.
This for the two.
More important to get her within a shot. Better hit it.
Oh, she hit it, man. All right. It's not over. Pressure pretty weak. Beth Daniel on 17. And I must say, Dave, that we have not seen this kind of pressure putting that I can recall in the closing holes of either a men or a women's U.S. Open. The gallery gathers to try to get a look at Pat Bradley perhaps winning her first U.S. Women's Open. But this shot is tight as far as the flag stick is concerned. For the right rough.
Just hit it
at the flag, but it's long.
Good shot.
Great shot. What a shot.
It's long.
Boy, come up into that wind and drop down just perfectly. Pat Bradley is going to win the U.S. Women's Open. I think we can say that now.
You can pretty well safely say that she's going to win. Now, if Daniel pitches in, that's one thing.
Yeah.
But if she were to make this birdie putt here, it would be 279 and a new record
for the Women's Open,
which will also be a little bonus.
Beth Daniel will have plenty more chances to go for this championship. Kathy Whitworth had her big opportunity today. good shot. Look at that.
All right. Good shot. Look at that.
She'd be trying to put it in the hole, and was that ever close?
A lot of things can happen between here in the clubhouse, James, my boy.
Now, Beth Daniel most certainly will make her birdie, it appears. It's a matter of inches. Then, Pat Bradley must make her birdie. Or else we go to Lamar.
Well, how many times in playing golf has this happened to you where you just started leaning on your club, whistling, and somebody just pitches it right up close to the hole, and the two-footer went to about 8 feet on you?
You say, what happens?
Yes, I thought I was going to win this easy.
Okay.
Great score, too, 280.
For Beth Daniel, a 4-under par, 68 today, 280 for the championship, 8-under, which ties the previous Women's Open record.
To be unlucky not to win, and that is really playing golf. 280, I don't care how long or short or whatever you want to call a golf course. Just all of you try to go out and shoot 70 each round for 4 days.
Now, Pat Bradley must make this birdie putt. I would say it's 2.5 to 3 feet. What do you say?
I'd say about 2 feet, Jim.
Okay. Very similar to Turnberry, remember, where Tom Watson seemed to have that British Open finally wrapped up in his head-to-head duel with Jack Nicklaus, but then Nicklaus wrapped a snake-like putt in, and suddenly it was a putt just like this that Watson had to make, which he did. Now Pat Bradley. She's done it.
Oh, all right.
Pat Bradley at 8:30 has won the U.S. Women's Open for the first time. Quite possibly not for the last. Going to 9-under par, she'll win that special prize of $25,000 along with the principal thing here, the trophy and the U.S. Open Championship. A round today of 6-under par, 66, which is a course competitive record for LaGrange. And now what a cheer when this one goes in. This little putt for a round of 68 today. Low round of the week. Nancy Lopez had a 69 earlier. And this putt for a 68. And most certainly the championship. Yes, it's there. And, oh, how about that? We have a new champion, and very well deserved indeed. The stalwarts, the champions, the more experienced players were the ones that fell by the wayside, and the crowd rise to greet a new champion, Janet Halleck. Well played indeed.
The woman on the right, Peter, is Hollis Stacy's mother, the member of the USGA Women's Committee. It was the first one to hug her.
Ah, that's nice. It must be a marvelous feeling. 70, 73, 72, and a 68 today. 283. Oh, now then. That's it. Well done.
Yeah, that's exactly right. You see now, as her stance is, she didn't really have interference by the card pass, so she was not entitled to a drop.
Got a tough shot now. Hurry.
She's played a great shot.
Oh, marvelous.
Beautiful shot.
Well, that should be a sure five. But let's wait and see. She's been putting so well all week. And remember, she's got 3 strokes.
Jack, this could be a big turnaround. Uh-huh. If she should happen to make this one, Stevenson goes 5-5.
And we're here tomorrow. Got a chance. Oh, what a lovely try. Didn't she just give it everything, huh? There's the gallery at 18, appreciating that marvelous putt by Patty Sheehan. Now we're down at the 17th, where Stevenson is on in 3 now on the par 4. She just made such a great shot at 12 there, from the right or left rough, wasn't it? get it up 4 feet to make birdie, and then she saved a marvelous par at 13. And she made a birdie on the front after a double bogey, and there's the kind of things that win championships. Look at this.
Oh, that is really good.
Oh, is that a lovely putt? That's a marvelous putt. Had a chance all the way.
She got the best she could do there.
Bogey five. That puts her at five over. Two-shot cushion coming up 18. Pat Bradley has just putted out in this competition. Patty Sheehan now for par to remain at plus seven, tied with Joanne Carner and two shots behind Jan Stevenson. Patty was the co-leader after the first round. She led after 36 holes, stumbled a little bit yesterday. Couldn't quite get a real charge going today. Yes, in with the par here at 18. Patty Sheehan completes the championship at plus seven, tied with Joanne Carner. And we'll go in and wait for Jan Stevenson to come up this par 4 18th hole.
Here is the woman of the hour. Jan Stevenson at age 31, 5 feet 5 inches tall, 115 pounds, proving once again that you need not be a giant to play this game.
Got to watch this ball doesn't go to the right because of the downhill lie with her feet above it. She's hit it right at the flag.
She sure has.
Got a left
there it
kick.
Is.
Beautiful shot, Jim.
Going to go off the back, but not too far. There we have it. Well, I don't know whether she's going to putt that, however, but she can make five here and win the championship.
That's, be a great win.
Not in, but good enough. The tap in will win the U.S. Women's Open for Jan Stevenson. She's done it.
It looked like she said, "I can't believe I won. I'm not good at beating lips, but."
She started the day at three over, finished at six over, around a three over par round of 74. Hollis with the shot. She started the day five over, was still five over until this. Until this. Look at this.
Wow.
Woo. Oh, dear.
It's just like Hollis, isn't it?
Does that get you back in the ballgame? Suddenly, Hollis Stacey is tied for the lead.
You remember yesterday how many putts she missed coming down the stretch? I mean,
well,
that...
she found another way.
To remain with a share of the lead. This is Hollis on the right, Amy on the left. Hollis has that for birdie at par five, while Amy's going for par. Oh, nice par, and almost a great birdie there by Hollis. Very fine, strong par there for, or a strong putt, rather, for a par she very much needed.
David, right through it. We have three people tied for the lead at two over. Amy Alcott, Rosie Jones, and Hollis Stacey.
Of course,
so
everything
did short of green mean.
Well, you could carry it on the green too, if it's an uphill line.
Hurry.
Better hurry there.
There it is, out to the left and bouncing onto the putting surface. It'll take a turn toward the pin. And from there, a fine, fine golf shot. Happiness is what that is.
Happiness is getting the ball over the water when you really need it.
For birdie.
Oh.
still going to be open.
Well, as long as she didn't make it, she put it in the right spot, Jack. Mm-hmm. Just a little straight in uphill there. She has to hope they don't do anything.
Yep, she has to sign the card and sit and watch the other two come in. Hollis Stacey finishing at plus two. That's a great round after that start.
Well done, Amy Elkopp, but congratulations to Hollis Stacey, the champ of Savannah GA, winning her third United States Women's Open here at the Salem Country Club.
Ooh, what a shot.
Is that any good, fellas, ladies?
Well, she got up and down so beautifully at the 13th.
Right at it.
I'll say.
All right, don't go away, ladies and gentlemen.
Sweet as a nut, that was back and through and in, and a rapier-like stroke from Kathy Baker, who really does look relaxed and happy, as if she's actually enjoying it.
I think she wants to get it up that bank, David. She doesn't want to leave it on that bank and let it trickle back off the green. I tell you, she's got to get it going, though. Oh, it's perfect.
Oh, yeah.
What a shot.
Look at this.
How about that?
As I said, I mean, she's got to bail out to the left. Well, that's you can get out the cake now and have the icing in the bowl, but don't quite take that knife to spread it out. Playing a third shot to the par 5, 17th hole, and just watch this. Looks as if it might just oblige, but dies 7 or 8 inches from the hole. She just went up and tapped that in for her birdie to put her stroke nearer. That's it. Par 4 for a round of 70. 2 under par today. 8 under par for the championship. The U.S. Women's Open Golf Champion, the national champion of 1985, is 24-year-old Kathy Baker of Clover, South Carolina.
Go.
Oh, hold everything. Hold everything, guys. Sally Little is not out of it. Goes to one under, just one stroke behind Betsy King.
All right, we have Jane Geddes at 17 for a birdie to go one under, and we have Betsy King here for a bogey to be one under. So Betsy King, who seems so much in control, double bogey 6 to go to even par. Sally Little leads the tournament at the moment. And this could put Geddes in a tie for the lead with Little.
That's it.
Oh, how about this?
That is it. Co-leaders, Little and Geddes.
I think Jane's going to have a little surprise run, I think, when she walks up on 18 or sees her next scoreboard that she's tied for the lead.
Okay. So she has her par on the 18th hole, a round of 69, not a bogey to be seen, and Jane Geddes could have put herself into a playoff for the U.S. Women's Open, could still conceivably win it today.
Oh, yeah. Boy, she had pulled out. I bet you're all
oh,
right.
Oh, boy.
Huh? Gave
her a push there. For Sally Little, a 2-under round of 70 today. She has tied for the lead in the Women's Open. Back at NCR, and there is the situation in the 18-hole playoff for the U.S. Women's Open Golf Championship. Way down in 76th place, but she seems to have the game back together. Finished 8th in Houston last week, and now, in this playoff, gets it up to the hole, certainly. A gorgeous shot.
That might put a little doubt in Jane's mind there. All had these kind of shots. It's not the easiest shot in the world. It may be short.
Well, it's at the hole, certainly, but short, short. So let's hang on here for a minute. But after all, the important thing for her was
to win.
To win, and to do it, and she felt it was the time. So she finished up. Jane Geddes has won the Women's Open. The new United States Women's Open Golf Champion, Jane Geddes of Irving, Texas, at age 26. She's never won before, so that's a new experience. Just for a birdie.
Shouldn't have much break here, Jim, this putt. If she'll keep it in the hole and just hit a good, solid putt.
There it is. We have a three-way tie for the lead. Okamoto of Japan, Davies of England, and 48-year-old Joanne Carner of the United States. Two-time champion, five-time U.S. Amateur champion, and look at the joy in that face.
Did it.
She did it.
Ooh, boy.
She's got it. She's got the lead in the Women's Open. Joanne Gunderson, who won her first U.S. Amateur Championship 30 years ago.
Leaderboard, as you see, through 13 holes. Laura Davies, the young English player. One stroke over Okamoto and two over Carner at this point.
Quickly, and she steps up and she hits the ball or puts the ball. I'm not sure that she's thinking this could be the biggest moment in her life right now. I think she's thinking about the putt she's putting.
Well, she just thought it out very well. I'll tell you that. All right. What a week for that young lady right there.
That just
puts her one under for the round, too, with a, depending on what happens with Ayako Okamoto there, that whether she makes hers or not, she's going to have a still at least a two-shot lead. Okamoto now with this birdie putt. And it's getting late in the day, Rhonda. She has to make this and get Laura Davies thinking a little bit about, well, it's not over yet.
She had to have that, David. You're right.
It's
going into 17, Laura has a chance of hitting that par 5 hole in two. I don't believe the other two players could do that today.
Okay, Okamoto for par 4, which would give her a round of 73. First time that she shot over par this week, and still a great tournament, fine tournament by Okamoto. What a nice player she is.
Oh, she's a champion.
I thought she might win. It seemed to me that the majors have been won by kind of quiet people this week, and this year, rather. And she's awfully quiet. Very nice. She's going to win a lot more. All right. Laura Davies can now two-putt to win the championship. And what you want to do is make it like a champion, like you really need it. Knock it in there. There she is, ladies and gentlemen. The USGA Women's Open champion, and a little kiss from her brother there. They've worked hard all week. It's been a long week for that young lady. Congratulations from Joanne Carner, gracious winner, gracious loser. Remember the shot she played yesterday at 16, Bob? After the, I forget who she played with. She took a wood and cut it in.
Boy, this one has the flag covered. It's going to be the perfect distance. Great shot.
Inexorable. It reminds me of the way Raymond Floyd gets when he wins tournaments.
Yes, sir. Wow.
Jack, that putt was a firm struck stroke. You can see the results. He really firmed it up the hill into the hole.
Fourth birdie on the back side. And a little unswedish like gesture there. Let's watch it again. Yes. 7 under. Five of the last six holes.
And remember, missed that very short putt.
He's a lot now for birdie on 16. This could really wrap it up. I think getting close is what she's after here. Or is she? Or is she? Do you believe that?
No.
Downhill, side hill. doesn't make any difference.
You told me how tough these greens were. You better talk to her about how to putt these greens.
One thing she has been known for, she is a great putter.
But you think about what she's done this week, 67, which was the lowest first round ever shot in a Women's Open and a course record then.
That was to mom and dad, the wave.
And 139 after two rounds, which tied that record.
And there it is, 69 today. She finishes seven over, wins by three, and you don't have to learn that gesture of throwing that ball to the crowd.
I think the Orioles could use her because she's got a better arm than some of your players, I'd say.
Great, you're right. With rounds of 67, 72, 69, and 69, three of the four rounds under 70 on the difficult Five Farms course.
While that was happening, it was Betsy King at 16. Now that puts her to seven under, five-shot lead. And the fat lady may have sung. All right. Get that one in anyway, Patty.
Yeah.
Our fans are great, aren't they?
Been a wonderful group of people here this week. Very, very nice, appreciative of the golf.
All right, now to put a period to it, and clinch the U.S. Open Women's Championship.
Even has a good arm.
Standing ovation here.